نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة حتى تركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار Verily, all the praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guide, none can lead astray. And whomsoever went astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. O you who believes in Allah, fear Allah in the way He should be feared, and I not accepting the state of Islam with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be needful to Allah who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam. And from him He created his wife. And from both of them He created many men and many women. Be needful to Allah from whom you demand your mutual rights. Keep tight relationship with your relatives, especially the kinship. Verily Allah is ever watcher upon you. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah and say the truth. He will rectify your deeds and He will forgive your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of actions are the newly invented matters in Islam, where every newly invented matter in Islam is innovation in Islam, and every innovation is in Islam is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. To proceed, my brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan season has finished. Ramadan season has finished. And in Ramadan, many people, they prostrated to Allah Azza wa Jal. Many people worshipped Allah Azza wa Jal. Many people took advantage of the month of Ramadan to be closer to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And it cured our heart. And it brought us closer to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We wept and cried and asked Allah Azza wa Jal and made dua. This is in the month of Ramadan. And Ramadan was for us like the water for the one who will be dying out of thirsty. And Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us with the month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal keep giving us opportunities one after another. That's why the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said alayhi salatu wa salam, all of you are going to enter Jannah except who reject. And then the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, O Messenger of Allah, who will be rejecting entering Jannah? He said alayhi salatu wa salam, whoever obeyed me, then he will enter Jannah. And whoever disobeyed me, he is the one who rejected. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to understand that in the month of Ramadan, we were keen to pray the five daily prayer. We were keen to read the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And some of us, or some Muslims, they went and did Umrah. And some of us, we tried to do our best to finish the Quran. And some of them has finished the Quran several times. And some of them, they have paid charity and given sadaqat to the needy ones. So my brothers and sisters, Ramadan was like an education institute for us. It educated us a lot of things and how to be a good Muslim, how to practice Islam in the perfect form. Like, but unfortunately, my brothers and sisters, many of us and many amongst us, when the month of Ramadan finishes, they go back to do the same habits, the same things that they used to do before the month of Ramadan. And we need to understand, my brothers and sisters, that from the sign that Allah Azza wa Jal has accepted our righteous deeds, that Allah Azza wa Jal will enable us to do more righteous deeds. And the sign that Allah Azza wa Jal did not accept our righteous deeds, that you will find people after doing the righteous deeds, they will follow it with evil deeds. And these are signs for us. So as soon as the Maghrib time comes in the month of, from the month of Ramadan, you'll find someone directly goes back to the same things that he used to do before, or she used to do before. So subhanAllah, that's why my brothers and sisters, the pious predecessors, the Salaf, used to make dua to Allah Azza wa Jal for 6 months, that Allah to accept them their previous Ramadan, 6 months after Ramadan, asking Allah to accept their righteous deeds in the month of Ramadan. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in a hadith, alayhi salatu wa sallam, educating the ummah, narrated by our mother, Aisha Ummul Mu'mineen radiyallahu anha, she said, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْبُ. The most dear deed to Allah Azza wa Jal are the deeds that constantly done, even if they were little. Those are the deeds that is dear and beloved to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave the best example alayhi salatu wa sallam. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well, she was following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the same hadith. وكانت عائشة, she was رضي الله عنها, إذا عملت العمل لزمته, if she did the righteous deeds, she will continue doing it رضي الله عنها وأرضاها. And as was narrated by علقمة, قال سألت أم المؤمنين عائشة, I asked the mother of the believers, عائشة, قلت يا أم المؤمنين, I said to her, oh mother of believer, كيف كان عمل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, what was the deeds of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then, هَلْ كَانَ يَخُصُّ شَيْئًا مِنَ الْأَيَّامِ, was he specifying his deeds or more in certain days more than others? And then she said, لَا كَانَ عَمَلَهُ دِيمَةً, that his deeds was constantly عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَأَيُّكُمْ يَسْتَطِيعُ مَا كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ يَسْتَطِيعُ, who's amongst you is able to do what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was able to do عليه الصلاة والسلام. And that's why in hadith of Bukhari, عن عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما قال, قال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا عبد الله لا تكن مثل فلان كان يقوم الليل فترك قيام الليل. He said to him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, to عبد الله ابن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما, he said to him, oh عبد الله, don't be like such and such individual. He used to do the night prayer sometimes, and he left the night prayer. SubhanAllah. That's why, my brothers and sisters, the scholars of Islam, they used to hate leaving the deeds and to stop the deeds, just only to take advantage of some season and then not to continue doing the righteous deeds after it. And don't be like those ones who worship the season, not worshipping Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. As well, the hadith of Aisha radiyallahu anha, another hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood. She said radiyallahu anha, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, qala kallifu min al-amali ma tutiqoon, meaning do the deeds which you are able to do it, fa inna Allah la yamallu hatta tamallu, Allah will not stop giving you reward until you stop your righteous deeds. وَإِنَّ أَحَبَّ الْعَمَلِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهُ وَإِنْ قَلْبُ. And the most dear deed to Allah Azza wa Jal are the deeds which is constantly done, even if it was a little. وَكَانَ إِذَا عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَثْبَتَهُ. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he was doing the righteous deeds, he will continue doing it alayhi salatu wa salam. The month of Ramadan is a month which is finished. The month which is finished. Now, did we reflect on the month of Ramadan? Did we gain? In the beginning of Ramadan, I mentioned in this very masjid, I mentioned that we should take advantage of the month of Ramadan. That we should take advantage of the month of Ramadan, that to gain the righteous deeds, and as well, and to gain the good habits, and to stop the bad habits. In this very masjid, I mentioned this, and I will repeat this. These good habits that we gain in the month of Ramadan, we should continue doing it even after the month of Ramadan. And this is the way of the righteous people. My brothers and sisters, there are certain things that we need to focus on about the month of Ramadan. That month of Ramadan was like a good guest, came to us, and as a blessed guest, came to us and surrounded us with a blessing. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So here, that's why after this guest has left, that the blessing that we gain, we should continue doing it after even the month of Ramadan finishes. And the second thing, as well, all of us, when the people of the month of Ramadan is started, we be happy and we be that Allah, alhamdulillah, that the month of Ramadan came and Allah has enabled us to witness another month of Ramadan. But after Ramadan finishes, this month of Ramadan will testify, and the days of Ramadan and the days after Ramadan will testify in our favor or against us in the day of judgment. It will testify either in our favor in the hereafter, or it will testify against us. So we shouldn't be a people who just only worship during the season and leaving the other seasons and leave the other days. And as well, one of the things that we should gain, don't be amongst those, or like those, like a woman. Allah Azza wa Jal has given an example. There is a woman was in Quraysh. She was literally spinning a cloth. She was making a cloth. Whenever she is finishing this cloth, then she will untie it again and start again. As Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in the Quran, وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثًا. Don't be like that woman, and she was an example in Quraysh, like that one who made, after spinning the cloth, and after the cloth is strong, and it become a good piece of cloth, after that, she used to untie it, and return it back to be strings again. So we shouldn't be like that. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, we should take advantage in the month of Ramadan, that at least, alhamdulillah, we spanned our clothes. We did our best to come close to Allah Azza wa Jal. And we made a pledge and a covenant between us and Allah Azza wa Jal that we should continue doing the righteous deeds. And don't make the month of Ramadan after, just as soon as Ramadan is finishes, then you go back in this, going back to do the same habits that we used to do before. And leave the covenant that Allah Azza wa Jal has favored us with during the month of Ramadan. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, we should think about all of these things. And Allah Azza wa Jal has given example again and again. Subhanallah. Allah has mentioned about from the people before us. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهُمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ عَنْهَا فَاتَّبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. That Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned, recite upon them the one which Allah Azza wa Jal has favored with his verses, and he started reciting the verses of Allah Azza wa Jal, then he was totally discharging himself from the signs and the verses of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the shaitan follows him, and he was amongst those one who follows their desire. Subhanallah. And Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned about him, وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفْعَنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنْ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. Subhanallah. That if Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned about him, that Allah, we could make him to be firm and to elevate his ranks in the hereafter, in this life and the hereafter. But he only just stick to the ground. He doesn't want to be lifted up from the ground. Subhanallah. These are a great example. And Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned about him, وَاتَّبَعَهُ. He followed his desire. فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ. His example like the dog, the example of the dog. إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَثْ. That if you carry something on a dog, it will keep breathing heavily. And if you remove it, keep breathing heavily. This is a sign from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is indicating us. Subhanallah. When Allah Azza wa Jal has favored us with his book and his verses and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and as soon as the Ramadan is finished, that we go back in the same way that we used to do before. Allahu musta'an. So there, my brothers and sisters, we should remember Allah Azza wa Jal is the Lord during the month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal is the Lord after, in the days after the month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal is there. And the opportunity Allah Azza wa Jal keep giving us again and again and again. And in every single last third of the night, Allah Azza wa Jal will be descending down to the first heaven for the people who missed the chance in the month of Ramadan. For the people who missed the chance, Laylatul Qadr. Allah Azza wa Jal in every single night, in the last third of the night, Allah will be descending to the first heaven, and Allah Azza wa Jal will call the people of earth, will call the people in the heavens and earth. Allah will call them. Is there anyone seeking forgiveness? I will forgive. Is there anyone making dua? I will accept their dua. Is there anyone seeking refuge? I will give refuge. Allah Azza wa Jal is coming and calling in every last third of the night. So that's why if we miss the chance, still we have opportunity to be closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوج المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد بن عبد الله على آله وصحبه وموالاه. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the Quran, the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah Azza wa Jal has owned that book. And Allah Azza wa Jal has owned this ummah, that he has revealed this book to this ummah. And Allah Azza wa Jal has owned Jibreel alayhi salam, that he came with that book. He came down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, educating him about the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah has revealed this book upon him alayhi salatu wa sallam. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored this ummah, that this book was revealed amongst them. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored everyone amongst us who read the Quran and teach the Quran, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said alayhi salatu wa sallam, خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best one amongst you are those ones who learn the Quran and teach the Quran. This Quran, it will be a shafi' for you in the day of judgment. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, fasting and the Quran will intercede for you in the day of judgment. The fasting will say to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, O Allah, I prevented him or her from eating and drinking and their desire from the morning until the evening. And the Quran will say to Allah Azza wa Jalla, O Allah, I prevented him from sleeping in the night. He was reciting me throughout the night. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla will enable them to intercede. This is the same book. And the one, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent it to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The same messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The one who is mercy to the mankind. The one who Allah has mentioned about him, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. He is the one who is merciful with the believer alayhi salatu wa salam. And the same one who Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned about him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you as a mercy to the mankind. And he is the same one who is merciful upon the believers. He will be complaining against us in the day of judgment to Allah himself. Allah has mentioned this in the Quran. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The messenger alayhi salatu wasalam will complain against all of us, those ones who abandoned the Quran. Allah said about this in the Quran. The messenger will complain to Allah Azza wa Jal in the day of judgment. He will say, Oh Allah, my people, they abandoned this book. They have abandoned the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And any of the scholars of Islam, they said, the one who doesn't read his mushaf for 3 days, then he is abandoning the mushaf, abandoning the Quran. 3 days. What about us? We only read Quran only once in the year, when Ramadan comes. And then we'll put the Quran on the shelf until the following Ramadan. And then we'll remove that pile of dust again from that Quran and we start again. Subhanallah. We're abandoning the Quran. And the consequence of that, our messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, our Shafi'i, he is the one who should be interceding for us, is going to complain to Allah Azza wa Jal against us if we abandon the Quran, the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, since the month of Ramadan was a month that we gain good habits by reading the Quran, we shouldn't abandon the Quran and keep us attached to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And as well, one of the things as well after the month of Ramadan, which we should remember, that the shaitan, still our enemy, even if the shayateen was locked in chains during the month of Ramadan, now they are released and they're going to come back again to us. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal has told us what is the solution dealing with them. Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. That Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned to us that the shaitan is your enemy, so take him as an enemy. Take enmity against the shaitan. You should take that shaitan as enemy, not your friend, not your companion, not the one who whispers to you and you listen to. Take the shaitan as your enemy. Subhanallah. Allah has mentioned about him, إِنَّمَا يَدْعُوا حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. He is calling his party to be amongst those of the people of the hellfire. So subhanallah, this is the duty of the shaitan. So we should take the shaitan as our enemy in order and seek refuge in Allah Azza wa Jal from the plots of the shaitan, in order to be closer to Allah Azza wa Jal and to protect ourselves by following the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and abstain ourselves from all evil deeds to be closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And as well, we should remember that after the month of Ramadan, all of us, we used to pray the 5 daily prayer as much as we can in the masjid. Now alhamdulillah, the masajid inshaAllah is going to be opening normally soon inshaAllah ta'ala. So that's why, attend the Jum'ah and the Jama'at, especially the Salawat, the 5 daily prayer, and try to pray in congregation. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to love this alayhi salatu wasalam. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, all of these things, we should take advantage that the month of Ramadan, we gain these habits. We should continue after the month of Ramadan. And the last thing as well, my brothers and sisters, that to have a good company. Our brothers around us will remind us about Allah Azza wa Jalla. People who remind us to implement the Sunnah. People will remind us to do the righteous deeds. This is what we should have. And that is the wallahi, this is one of the best ni'mah after Tawheed. The best ni'mah that after Tawheed, that Allah made us Muslims and following the path of Allah and His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, is one of the best ni'mah, one of the best favors of Allah Azza wa Jal, that Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ أَخْوَةً. Verily, the believers are brothers. Our brothers. So that's why, keep the believers as your brothers and have a good company around you. And after the month of Ramadan, we used to give charity during the month of Ramadan. We should continue giving charity for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And remember that sometimes, even subhanallah, Allah, even some people, Allah Azza wa Jal, during the season of Hajj, and it was said about Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, rahimahullah, he was a great scholar and a great worshipper of Allah Azza wa Jal. He had the money with his student. They wanted to go Hajj, to do Hajj. In the season of Hajj, on the way, they saw a bird, a dead bird on the way. And then they found a young girl, she came and she took the bird. And then he said to her, what do you want to do with it? She said, I'm going to take it to my family to eat. And then he said, it's haram, you cannot eat a dead animal. And then she said, we have nothing, if we didn't eat it, we're going to die. And then he took all the wealth of the Hajj, which he prepared for the Hajj. And he gave it to her, all of it, give it to her. And then he returned back with his camel back to Iraq. Mm-hmm. And then when his student, he said to him, why do you want to go back? He said, this is our Hajj for this year. This is our Hajj for this year. So that's why the sadaqah, when in a need, in a time of a need, it is more important than even paying the sadaqah in a time where it is in high season, or in a season where there is the reward is multiple, when there is a need. And our brothers and sisters are suffering all around the world, in Palestine. Make dua for them. Our brothers and sisters, they are suffering. They're being killed and tortured. And our brothers and sisters in Sham. And our brothers and sisters in Kashmir. And our brothers and sisters in China. And our brothers and sisters in Burma. And our brothers and sisters in Africa. All our brothers and sisters, they're suffering. and they are enemy. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will question us in the day of judgment about them. The minimum thing that we can do, just make dua for them, that Allah Azza wa Jalla give them the support and Allah Azza wa Jalla give them the help during this peak time for them. May Allah Azza wa Jalla help them and reward them and bless them and help us to help them in the best way that we can. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكته القدس فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكروا اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأجل وأتم وأكبر وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استقيموا اعتدلوا استووا straight in the line. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.